Hey, on Study Circle. Today we will start a new session on today important daily current affairs, 25th 3rd 2020. First topic is Amendment Finance Act passed. Parliament on 23rd March 2020 passed amendment to the Finance Act with the introduction of mandatory threshold of rupees 50 lakhs for taxing non-resident Indian or NRI and equalization levy for e-commerce operators. The increased tedious compliance for the cash withdrawal by those who haven't filed income tax return of 3 years and lower rate tax collected source for remitting education loan money overseas as some of the amendment introduced. The main point is, the first point is the liability to pay on tax such deemed resident will be only the respect of business controlled in India. Second point, further, such person has been categorized as not ordinary resident if they reside in the India for the 120 or more than but less than 182 days. Third point is the government also expanded the ambit of the equalization levy for non-resident e-commerce operators involved in such of service including online sales of goods on provision of service with the levy at the rate of 2%. Fourth point, equalization levy at 6% has been enforced since 2016. Fifth point, lowered TCS rate to 0.5% from 5% for transfer of money overseas through liberalized remittance scheme. Sixth point is compliance levies on cash withdrawal or Rs. Rupees 1 crore. Seventh point is the government has withdrawn 0.1% TCS for being applicable to exporters. Ninth point is Union Budget 2021 has 10% tax exemption on long-term capital gains, dividend and interest on investment to infrastructure made by the sovereign wealth fund. This next today current affairs. Now, Hantavirus virus in China. Next virus found in China name was Hantavirus virus in China. Even the coronavirus outbreak take the world by storm, a number of other diseases are also raining the ugly head. Cases of swine flu and bird flu have already been reported in India and other countries. Now, a man from China had tested positive for Hantavirus virus. The men are from Yunnan province died who have lived by the Shangguo province for work as on the bus on the 23rd March 2020. What is the Hantavirus virus? According to the Center of Disease Control Prevention, CDC, Hantaviruses are the family of virus which are spread mainly by rodents. Second point is it can cause Hantavirus pulmonary syndrome, HPS, and hemorrhage fever with Raynal syndrome. Third point is the disease is not airborne and can only spread to the people they came into contact, urine, faces and saliva of rodent. The symptom of this Hantavirus, every symptom has HPS include fatigue, fever and muscle ache, along with the headache, dizziness, chill, abdominal problems. HPS cannot be passed on from person to person, while HFRS transmission between people is external layer. As per the CDC, radiant population control is a primary strategy for preventing hantavirus infection. Hantavirus pulmonary syndrome. What is hantavirus pulmonary syndrome? Hantavirus pulmonary syndrome is a severe, sometimes fatal respiratory disease in human caused by the infection with the hantavirus. Anyone who came into contact with the radiant that carry hantavirus at risk of HPS radiant infection and around the home remain the primary risk for hantavirus exposure. To date, no cases of HPS have been reported in the United States in which the virus was transmitted from the one person to another person. In Chile and Argentina, a rare case of person-to-person transmission have occurred among close contact of a person who has been type of hantavirus cause Aedes virus. Next topic is direction under the BOCW Welfare CES Act. What is BOCA? BOCW Welfare CES Act. In first major step of unorganized sector to tide over the COVID-19 pandemic during the lockdown, the central government on 24th March 2020 directed the state to transfer cash into the bank account of contractor workers from unutilized welfare fund. Building and other construction worker welfare CES fund. There is about 34 million contractor workers in the country registered under the Building and Other Contractor Workers Welfare CES Act 1996. What is the BOCW? The government has evolved Section 60 of the Act to issue direction to the state government frame a scheme for transfer of adequate fund in the bank account of contractor workers. Second point is amount to be granted to construction workers may be decided by the respective state government and union territories. The country had about 50 million contractor workers and the state also launched a drive to register more workers under the act. These are the main point for BOCW Welfare CES Act 1996. Next is World Tuberculosis Day 2020. Every year on March 24, World Tuberculosis Day is marked and raises awareness about the disease, most infected killer on the world. According to the World Health Organization WHO, the public is made aware about the negative consequences of TB with regard health, society, economics. What is Tuberculosis Day? The day marks anniversary of the discovery of the TB causing bacteria, which is discovered by Dr. Robert Koch in 1882. Discovery helped the diagnosis and care of the disease. The significance of World Tuberculosis Day is to spread awareness regarding TB, which has been tagged by the WHO as a deadly infection. The disease, according to a WHO report released on October 2019. Tuberculosis in India. The WHO also categorizes India among the top 30 critical countries bounded in the threat of TB. According to the WHO, the theme of World Tuberculosis Day 2020 is the motto of It's Time to End TB. It's Time to End TB. Next topic is India's first dedicated coronavirus hospital. Mukesh Ambani led Reliance Industries Limited, RIL, has announced a slew of measures to fight to delay coronavirus or COVID-19, including setting the India's first dedicated COVID-19 hospital, special quarantine facility, boarding additional test kit, and enhancing the production capabilities to produce lakh face masks per day. Within the 2 weeks, Sir H.N. Reliance Foundation Hospital, in collaboration with the Bahrain Mumbai Municipal Corporation (BMC), has set to the dedicated 100-bedded center, the Seven Hills Hospital, Mumbai. Next topic is Cabinet approved MOU signed between the India and Germany enhance railway sector. The Union Cabinet led by the PM Narendra Modi appreciated the Memorandum of Understanding signed between Ministry of Railway, GOL and DB Engineers and Consulting GmbH of Germany. The main features of this MOU. First feature is the MOU will flight operated or passengers operation and infrastructure building and management between the countries in the railway sector. It will be enhance the development of modern competitive railway organization, IT solution for the railway operation, marketing and sales and administrative purpose. It will be also improve predictive maintenance private train operators between the two parties. Next topic is scientists say Sikkim glaciers are the most faster than the other Himalayan. Scientific from the Valdia Institute of Himalayan Geology, Dehradun, found the glaciers in Sikkim are melting at the higher magnitude as compared to other Himalayan region. Study. What is the significance? The scientific assessed to respond of 23rd glaciers of Sikkim to climate change for the period of 1991 to 2015. It relevant believed that the glaciers of Sikkim has retained and glaciers significantly from 1991 to 2015. Small sized glaciers in Sikkim are retreating while larger glaciers are thinning due to the climate change. The western and central Himalaya glaciers are reported to have the slowdown in recent decade, but Sikkim glaciers have slow negligible declaration of after 2000. Valdia Institute of Himalayan Geology. Valdia Institute of Himalayan Geology as a research institute for the study of geology of the Himalaya under the development of science and technology, Ministry of Science and Technology, GOL. It was established in 1968. It was located in Dehradun in Uttarakhand of India. It was provided and advisory service of various organizations of geotechnical feasibility of merger and minor hydro project, site selection of bridges and their foundation, slope stability and control of landslide, site selection, deep two wells, among others. ARC. Next topic is ARC developing technology to improve fuel efficiency internal combustion engine. This is an engine. What is a ARCA? International Advanced Center for Powder Metallurgy new material developed in ultra fast laser surface detection technology. The technology can improve the fuel efficiency of internal combustion engine. Main highlight is laser surface micro texturing offer precise control of size and shape. The density of micro surface texture feature gain memorandum as a wall of control friction and wear. The special feature of technology is pulsating laser beam create micro dimple or grooves on the surface of malaria in the very controlled manner. The texture of troop where debris was operating under the dry sliding condition. Next topic, International Day of Solidarity with the detained or missing staff members observed 25th March. This is the main. International Day of Solidarity with the detained and missing staff members is observed on 25th March. The day has to remember the fallen person who served for the cause of peace in the violent world since the United Nations founding. Over 3,500 brain men and women. The main aim, the day aim to mobilize action, demand justice and strengthening staff in the non-governmental community and the press. History, the history of the International Day of Solidarity and with detained or missing staff. Main history is, the day is marked on the anniversary of the abduction of Al Collett. He was the former journalist who worked in the United Nations Relief and Work Agency for Palestinian Refugee in the Near East. He was abducted by armed gunmen in 1985. His body was found in the Lebanon Bekaa Valley in 2009. The first resolution of staff security was adopted with the United Nations Security Council in September 1993. Next topic is, Central Bank exported hydroxychloroquine drugs. Yesterday, the medicine was suggestion for the COVID-19. Today, the central government banned this medicine. India banned export of anti-malaria drugs hydroxychloroquine on 25th March with immediate effect. The drug hydroxychloroquine is believed to have some positive effect on the treatment of coronavirus, but the export from special economic zone and other GOL appreciate exporters only will be allowed to the export the drug. The main aim, the move by the government is aimed to prevent any scope of export of ventilators by alternative classification in view of the growing number of cases of COVID-19 in India. Other measures, GOL has banned export of sanitation on 24th March. Central extended banned ventilators, artificial respiratory apparatus, oxygen therapy apparatus and other breathing application to plug any loopholes in export of this critical healthcare item during the COVID-19 pandemic. Earlier, the DGFT banned the export of surgical and disposable mask, all ventilators and texture raw material used for the making mask with immediate effect. Thank you. Study well. Fall, stand, learn, adopt.